Yo, Esperin, how's it going? How are you doing? Almost forgot about that guy. Bad. Okay. Yeah, this is this part. Shintok, how's it going? Yeah, this game is real good. So screwed. Oh, yep, super screwed now. I'm gonna get caught. I think I'm. Yeah, I have to be riding anyway. Yeah. Bummer. Yo, Misty, how's it going? Yeah, palette shifting's real good in this game. That's not good. I need to get up there. Oh, that's... No, I know what I need to do. I was skipping ahead. Hey, Kate Libsy. How's it going? Yeah, it's a really, really, really good game. Anybody who makes a game that plays on an actual hardware, you know, Mega Drive in 2018 definitely deserves community support. I forgot. That's... I wasn't supposed to go in there yet. Yep. Yeah. This is why it's a no-strat speedrun. Second time ever playing the game. Haven't even looked at strats yet. Yeah, coming up, I get a new superpower, and for some reason in my head, I was getting the superpower on the previous... Yeah, it's a game involving a fox with really good controls. Coming out of those jumps, the game really does not like letting me grab or move anything. Nice. Good navigation. Shuriken, thank you very much for the host. Actually up there. Shuriken, this is a brand new game that just came out, which you'll notice I'm playing on my Mega Drive. It's really, really good. It is super fun. You know, I did that in my blind playthrough too. Yeah, I can't name a single animation in this game that isn't just superb. Okay. Well, I didn't own myself on spikes that time at least. I guess actually using the down button would have made that better, but... Those swirls will ruin your day. Oh no, I need you. Thank you. This part sucks. Okay. So if you just do that part as quickly as possible, apparently you don't get owned by the wind. I swear I hit the C button. Kidprit, thank you so much for 12 months in a row. That is immensely generous of you. No, this is what I was afraid of. Don't do this. Yeah, that's fair. There's some tumbling. There's some tumbling in these woods. Oh, this level sucks. No, is it this level? I think it's next level. This level has many problems, but the one that I was thinking of was not among them. Alright, good news. You can't accidentally kill yourself by touching spikes the wrong way. That's right. Got there. Please don't corner yourself. Go away. This is the level that I hate. It works. It's fair. Yeah, Mellows. This one's real fun. And I figure if our blind race took me 2.5 hours, then I should be able to finish this in like 1.5 or so. Gonna be real honest, that part wasn't smart. Okay. That part was less smart. This part was frustrating. I don't think I'm gonna make it. I'm definitely gonna make it. I did. I made it. Okay. Cool. Even if you're covered up by a tree, if you're in the air, you get... Can I go three trees? Nope, not now, I can't. I could've. So, from the chat, I can go three trees, I think. I think I can normally go three. Nope, I can only go one after that. And I need to not be an idiot. This was the single longest segment in my blind playthrough, so it's not a huge surprise that it is similarly presenting a challenge in my first run. That's how we do it. Okay. That's fine. We're learning timing. The lightning is always equally spaced, but there's really no telegraph at all. Other than you dying. You dying is a relatively effective telegraph. Except that it happens after the fact. Some might argue makes it less of a effective telegraph. I don't know. Maybe. This is a topic for philosophers to figure out, not me. Could have gotten it all the way. And now I'm gonna wait. I've died getting that power up before, and it's a real bad feeling. Hello, friend. Speaking of bad feelings, That's also a bad feeling. Oh. Yeah, it turns out that this fox is just really, really ferocious. There we go. Now I'm getting the speed strats. I don't think this is the speed strat. Got there. Easy. Easy game. The worst. Not great. Yeah, the lightning's the only real part of the game that I would say does not feel fair. I'm I'm also not convinced that mashing there does anything, but I'll never not mash. I think I did that in my blind playthrough too, assuming that there was gonna be more puzzle. Don't worry, there are really compelling reasons to want to play this game instead of something like Donkey Kong Country. By all means, push. You can do it. I believe in you. In fact, we're coming up on some really compelling reasons to play this game already. I died. If you let that one go down too far, it bugs the game out until you die. I discovered that during my blind playthrough. Also, there are spikes there. Hey, Kashire, how's it going? I don't remember where I'm supposed to glide. Not here. I need to get down there somehow. That's where I'm supposed to glide. Found it. We'll have you all know that I did not die there in my blind playthrough. Free time save, though. Just don't die like an idiot. Really? Gonna be real with you, that's not what you want to do here. Somehow it worked. Two ways I want to go first. I think it's this way. Either I'm right or I'm dead. That's right. This way. That was too much. That was pushing just a little bit too much. I forget if there's anything over this way that I can use. There is. It's that. And I just made it so that I can't use it. Let's restart. Magitek! Tanglewood is super fun. Strong recommend to anybody who's got 18 bucks to spare. Thank you. never noticed the foot... The foot sounds. Footfall sounds. That is a really nice touch and very cute. And now we can glide over the corpse. Oh no! Jump! Yes, it is both fun and super cute. You're sad we don't get to see more happy red fluffies? Yeah. That's a mechanic that, like, this level and the mine really explore. No, don't you dare, you... I know you want me to carry you. But you jumped. You were more than halfway through. You could have just gone. Also, it's worth noting that you have an awoo button. Poor Leno, thank you very much for the sub. 2 months in a row, that is super generous and very appreciated. Get there. There's a warthog there. Decidability, how's it going? I know. The problem is that when your companion starts a-wooing, you're on a timer before you have to be in the same spot. Otherwise, she just dies, you know, like you do. I did that twice. Yeah, a lot of the music is just really top-notch. There's an option. I didn't show it off because I just went straight into the game, but there's an option to turn on and off support for the old Yamaha chip. I suspect that the way that they did the music is different depending on... I keep on being in the middle of a sentence and just running headfirst into that warthog. That warthog, as good of an enemy as the Goomba in 1-1. Anyway. I suspect that they do something different with the music if you have that turned off, which probably means that they have different musicality for the later generation Sega consoles, just because the non-Yamaha chips sounded worse. All right, I swear, I'm not gonna get owned. Hey, I didn't get owned. This level took so much longer than it should have. Dragon Lord Carter, how's it going? Real? Come on, let's go. Can I? That's right. Right. I know what I'm missing. That's exactly why I needed the yellow boy. I just have to remember how to get there now. Guess it's not this way. Yeah, no. Oh. Duh, it's right there. Come on. Please get on. The save point is active. If you don't get on the boat right now. Oh, that's why. Okay. Well, I guess that makes sense. No. Yeah, the anglerfish's sound is real good. Come on up. Nope, too far away. That's gonna be death. Come over here. One of those again, huh? This will be the only really, really frustrating part of this speedrun, I feel. Is your partner's AI pathing can be real wonky at times. Please don't die. Okay, cool. That's slow. That's right, this is where you learn about cages and how cages aren't good. You learn the dubious moral of the story, which is you can put someone else in a cage instead. I have some qualms about that particular life lesson, but you know. It is what it is. That's right, it's time for this dude. Thank you. Oh, wow. I don't know how I killed him in two hits. He's supposed to be a three-hit boss. I did something there that double-hit him, which is pretty cool, and I sure would love to know how to duplicate. Alright. Faster just holding the water, that's good to know. That's the exit. Nope, can't do that. Yep, that's where I want to be. Hopefully I don't have to go back down and get yellow again. Nope, sure don't. Cool. I just have to find a red boy. Somewhere. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, potential for a single hit kill is totally there. No reason why not. Okay, lots of rocks. Need a red dude. Lots of rocks. Making sure that I know that the red dude's gonna come from the right. Okay. No. Come back up. There you go. We're still even on the same screen. That is unacceptable. He's back on this side. It's fine. That's right. You know how she refuses to swim? Also, the surface effects are teensy bit buggy here. Seems to check for only X coordinates, not also Y. For whatever reason, this spot in the mines just really likes to have the partner AI glitch out and have the partner just up and die for no good reason. It's very important that you stay hydrated. Okay. The partner will sometimes just make a beeline for the left there and run straight into a pit of spikes, which is suboptimal in that it respawns you. I was not supposed to come down here without a fuzzy. Try. There you go. Got it in two. Okay. It's fine. Let's just reset that timer. Get you over here and jump. This ain't it. Okay, that's a cool glitch speed tech thing for later. That's good to know. My partner's gonna be dead soon. Nope, we're good. I missed you. More importantly, oh, okay. You're just gonna go that way, huh? Cool. are you doing? Please. Don't give me a game over. This is terrible. Calling it now. Gonna die. From being too far apart. But I mean, the AI's glitched. There's nothing that I can do about that one, so. Okay. Ironically, I need something that only my partner can get me. So that's good. Alright, buddy. Let's go back over this way, shall we? There we go. Alright, that's how I fix that AI glitch. Got it. Yeah, you won't jump off. 88DreadGT, thank you very much for the host. Welcome, everyone. Nice try. Let me stay in front. Please don't run ahead of me. Pretty please. If you die, I die in real life. You know that blue fuzzy that I had? Alright, you take blue fuzzy, put it in lamp. There we go. Wasn't a bug per se. Oh no. rolling it the wrong way. This is right. Come on, buddy. Come on down. You've got to come with me. The game will yell at me if you don't. Also, you'll die. Because of the way that the dog moves, it is faster to have the companion AI push this. Because the dog will always run in front of you and try and stop you from moving the thing. Yeah, Dairyberry, this game is super cute. It's so good. Seer Sky, hope you're doing well. Hope things are going well. Bye, doggy. Oh yeah, you're introduced to this happy white fluff ball at the start of the game. It's a nightmare creature from Nightmares. Yeah, Bible thumps. That's a good reaction. Also, I want to point out the use of dissonance there. I think that it does a very, very good job of setting the mood for what just happened and kind of giving you an idea of what your new player character is thinking. Not sure if this is faster. Because it's water, this might be faster. Oh yeah, the scene was just expertly done. Something above me I have to handle. Yeah, this level is incredibly well done from an artistic standpoint. I love it. They also avoid putting you in a position that would be confusing, where you have to figure out, like, which power-up did I just get? They put you in that position, but it turns out that they make it very easy to suss out what you've been given. Forgot about that. Thank you. Oh yeah, this level. That was smart. Okay, that was even less smart. Yeah, I mean, maybe clip that. We can send that along to the devs and ask them, hey, what gives here? Chomp. So, I agree with you to start, but one thing to temper that just a little bit is to remember that one thing that has changed between, you know, when these consoles were quote-unquote relevant and today is that there's a lot more and better tooling available. So you see there how my save light turned yellow. That was the hint. Perfect. Perfect jump. Oh yeah, for sure. But honestly, I think that this could have been released years ago. I'm botching this. I'm beefing it. But yeah, this could have been released when this console was relevant. The big thing that's changed is that a lot of people, a lot of really, really smart, talented people have worked really hard to make sure that good tooling is available not just to, you know, game studios, but to everyone. And that makes such a huge difference. Where are you? I hear you. There you go. Get on. No! Oh, that was my fault. It was entirely my own doing. almost forgot. It's like, that's not just a plot device. That's not just to save you. You have to use that. Sandworm time. Down here. Thank you. Supposed to be able to jump into that. Gotta go there. That's right. Rocket launcher. Yeah, this is my first time speedrunning this. I did a blind race against Melisoro, Author Blues, Liz, those three last night, and it was super fun. I feel like I didn't need yellow there. Not sure what I got yellow for now. Bad feeling I need yellow now. And I died. That's probably what it is. I probably need yellow now, so I should have attracted the worm. That's fine. That's okay. Munch. Yeah, rocket launcher. It's really, really fun. It is definitely worth a look for anybody who's interested in retro games, Mega Drive games. It is a fantastic example of both. But I needed the glide for. Okay. Yeah, there's no way. Okay. So I do need glide, and then I'll probably want to get glide again. That's my guess. Need to figure out a faster way to do this. I'll open it up sometime in task rules and figure it out. There's a few. If you're into RPG speedrunning, there is the RPG Valkyries. I just threw that one away, I guess. Didn't get there. But yeah, RPG Valkyries, there's Girls on Fire, which is just in general. Speedrun. There we go. And then outside of that, just like groups of friends is pretty much it. Perfect. Yeah, that was a log. It's much more obvious when it's not when it's not black and white because time has stopped. Push. Thank you. Wrong way. Oh, that's right. This is a real huge pain in the butt. This way? Yeah, I think it's that way. Yeah. Somehow. Nice. Got there. My fault. Totally my fault. Still, bummer. Starts from the left. Yeah, you stutter it to go faster, because when you're pushing, the object will warp to you. The animation is really, really good, and it's super cute, and also it's not fast. Oh no. Okay. Nice. Yeah, Garrett, the sandworms are really, really mean. They are very good at eating you. Where's my little white boy? Have you ever been so mad that you just killed someone? My one weakness, taking damage. Okay, I will admit that. That was, in fact, not a little. That was not a little boy. Come on. Let's turn into death again. Thank you. Did that in my blind playthrough too. You're so used to going slow that it's very easy to just jump right into the boulder. Cannot believe that I got killed there. This is the easiest fight. This isn't Adlib music, this is Yamaha music. first generation of Sega, Mega Drive, Genesis, whatever you want to call it, had a Yamaha FM synthesis chip in it, and it's real good. It makes a lot of just really fantastic sounds. It was a shame. Genesis is kind of known for, overall, the library having kind of a lackluster. I don't want to be over here. But sonically, it's like kind of lackluster. It's just, it's not where the Super Nintendo was on average in terms of like sound and music. But the thing is that that had nothing to do with the technical capabilities of the Mega Drive Genesis. I'm gonna die. I forgot about this part of the cutscene. I'm totally gonna die. Yeah, AdLib also did FM synthesis, which is why you would be associating what you're hearing right now with the AdLib. AdLib was a great, great card chip. It was real good. It's not too bad for a first speedrun ever. Let the credits play out. Almost an hour faster than my blind run, so. Oh, the AdLib used a Yamaha chip. There you go. I knew that it did FM synthesis. I didn't realize that it was also Yamaha. Thank you for the GG. Did an interesting mod for Genesis. You can swap between the original Yamaha chip and a higher tier one from the same era. That's interesting. The only two chips that were ever in the Genesis were a Yamaha chip and then a clone of the exact same chip that was put into the second and third generation. And the clone just did not sound as good. Shintok, if you can locate that video, I would love to see the difference between those two. Awesome. A whisper would be optimal, if that's okay. Yeah, to my earlier point, like, all of this open source software, like, that is... If people wanted to get into retro game creation now, like, creation for retro systems, this is the time. There are so many good resources, and there's so much tooling and support built up around, you know, these older systems, computers or consoles, both. It is a real good time to get into developing for these older machines. We've seen a few so far. We've got Lizard for the NES. We've got this game, of course. There's a simpler but still quite fun game for the Game Boy called Tobu Tobu, which was, I think, Swedish. But there's a lot of good stuff coming out.